Hey Yen Noodles, and welcome back to Idle Heroes and to this channel. Today we got plenty to talk about. Just again, the Profit Orb event arrived, so let's get right into it. Okay, so first of all, let's talk about the event itself. We have a Celebration of Glory currently going for 2 weeks, that is, which means that the daily campaign rewards are doubled, which is great to level up. I think we might be able to get our new Heart Watcher copy just tomorrow, which would be absolutely awesome. The first time to replenish your gems event is a reset, which means that all of this stuff was reset. I was doing a bit of it already, I think, at least. Then we have the carnival box. You can get carnival box by buying them with gems, or you can just read it out of this little box. Was it? I think, yeah. You can pretty much get them by daily gifts, or you buy them by gems. If you're a spender, you can get them through these packages here as well. Oh wait, there's a Gustin skin. Okay, Gustin got a funny new skin as well. But let's say right here really quickly. So, the way these boxes work pretty much is you get four contains three heroes from a day. No. You get 3-star hero shards. But how many? 5 random different heroes, and then if they are of a identical faction, you get some extra bonuses, which can also include, if it's 4 heroes, you can get an extra 5 hero shard, or if they are all from the identical faction, like all 5 heroes, you'll get an elite 5-star hero shard, which is pretty cool. It's pretty much for free. It's kind of funny. A box costs 150 gems. Here you can see how you get these. So it's a fun gimmick. I would not advise you spending any gems to it though, or for it. Don't spend any gems. Just don't. Then we have Grey Wolves Blessing. Pretty much just the same. Just Beautimus. You can upgrade your gear here, which is not really important. Then you have the value packages, which I do not care about at all. And then we come into the juicy stuff. You get these glory chests, which you can open for some extra, as you can see, some extra resources pretty much. The prices are 4-star light and dark star. Dark, 4-star dark, my goodness, I was confused right there. Then we have a Abyss 5-star, a Forest 5-star, a Dark, a Light 5-star, Heart Watcher up here, and a Michelle. On this account here, I'm not going to be able to finish this this profit event just yet. We are at 36, I can still buy like 2 orbs, or almost 3 orbs actually over here, but we're just not far enough. I'm going to do some Triumph Champion after. I'm going to do some Triumph Champion afterwards, trying to farm some more coins, so that we get some more profit orbs. But event rate is also doubled. So as you can see, we have 250 here. If we just smash it once, we get 500k, which is really important. Don't forget to do your daily smashes of what even is that? Event rate. Yeah. Because you get just free stuff out of it by clicking the button 6 times pretty much, which is lovely. Okay, that was this event almost explained. We got here we come to the free to play aspect. Okay, so you might not be able to complete it yet, which is no problem. You should always focus though to get at least these two, the light and the dark star hero, because it basically means that every second heroic miracle, which this is, you can get the two light star fives and the two dark star fives out of the way, which gives you 10 profit orbs, some gear, and it also gives you, well, here it is a mim. We're going to talk about these in Well, I can talk about them right now, actually. I think it's the Dark Spirit, yeah, and this is Disciple? No, Divine Spirit. Oh my goodness, names. Me and names. They're just fodder heroes. Heartwatcher, she's great for PvE. As I said, she's stacking some damage. She's critting, and by critting, she is healing herself. And she pretty much just increases the whole damage of your team, which is just lovely. You absolutely want that if you are focusing on PvE. Then Michelle. Michelle is a mid-tier light hero, so you should definitely not focus her if you want to focus a light or a dark faction. I'm not advising you to do so if you're free to play, because it's horrifically hard. Well, what Michelle pretty much does is she has a chance to heal. Well, she does heal an ally. She also is control immune by 50%. If she dies, she's being resurrected, which is pretty cool. And then you have the holy damage, just passives. She can also stun, I think. Yeah, 35% chance to stun. 3 random enemies for 2 rounds, which can be useful and which saved my booty in Sealand on my main account. So that is talking about Michelle and Heartwatcher. Heartwatcher, a great hero, go for it. If you want to build light as a free-to-play peep, pretty much only go for Ada for sure. Whoops, wrong. Ada, yeah, that's it. If you build any hero out of light faction, probably go only for Ada. I'm building a Belrain on my main because she is kind of a good PvE hero, but I would not advise you to do so because she can't carry. If you're on dark faction, you have a bit more of variety, I'd say. You can go for Aspen, you can go for Amun-Ra as well. Amun-Ra is not a PvE hero though. And as a free-to-play peep, you probably do not want to focus PvP, because people are just taking off, like, as you can see, I'm trying to play this account like optimal. I'm at rank 267. My defense is looking like this, which is not bad, but look at these peeps. Like, they are so much further in progress than me. Look at that. Wow. Like, they're crazy. Crazy spenders do exist. It is free to play. That is... what the hell is that? Blue stacks. Stop messing with me. I don't care about that. What we're going to do today, though, is we're going to pump some stuff into forest. And I guess let's just... I'm going to smash a bit here. And trying to get the 40. So, I'll see you just in a second. I'll cut this definitely out because it is not too exciting. Wait, this is the wrong arena. Yeah, see you in a second, peeps. Okay, I'm still figuring out because I didn't get as many points as I would have liked to. I'm at 172, I need like 30 more to get my 40 full. So what we're going to do here is we're going to do some spinning right now. Well, not spinning, we're going to spend our forest orbs here, and we'll see what we'll get, I guess. Let's get right into it. Let's see. Let's hope for Valk or something like that. Who knows? Okay, starting off very, very poorly. Oh, whoa. Come on, game. Nice. I tell you, this account's luck is just I don't even understand it. Like, I don't even understand it. Yeah, give me those three branches. Here we get our little rewards. What is this? Oh, okay. I'm a big dum-dum. Yeah, I am. We did get our few. And a melassa, let's go. Hell yeah. Okay. Now, what we want to do is we want to get these out. 8 in total. Wait, we can't even, can we? That's 6. Oh yeah, it's 8. Okay. Only one Dragon Slayer, which is not too great. I would have hoped for more forest, but this is fine. We got 2 Shadow, 3 Shadow, 3 Abyss, 1 Fortress, and 1 Forest. So what we'll do here is, I think we're going to, let me see, what do you need, Heart Watcher? You need a Grey Eyed, okay. We don't have a Grey Eyed, and I don't think we can build one. No, we can't. Okay, which is not a problem, because we're going to summon out Demon Hunter, and we're going to summon out, I forgot his name, but we're going to summon him out. Also, what do we need? We need, Abyss, which we don't have. Not Abyss, for feck's sake, what am I saying? We need Fortress, yeah. Right? So we are doing... Wait, are we done? Oh no, we aren't. So, right now we did some of the heroic miracle. We need like 2 more fortress, but like honestly, that's not the most important stuff right now. Let's scroll through our equip here. I was just trying to optimize what I had right there. So we did pull out some forest stuff, and we are going to make our Valk a bit stronger, I think. Honestly, I think 7 slot is a good idea to get her going. Do we want to do that? We can like forge up somebody. Who do we have? We have one of these. We can build them. No, we can't. We have some of those, but do we have the ones she requires? No, we don't. We have these thingies, so if we have a Thale, which we do, we can absolutely get that going. Should be enough to build a Thale. Yes, it is. Oh, look at that. Yeah, like this. Lovely. Okay. So this means that we can indeed make our Valk a bit more awesome. The question is, do we want to do that right now? I'm thinking right now, because thinking as a free-to-play player, the next time we're going to get like huge team upgrades, so it's probably next profit orb event. I'm thinking about maybe keeping this doohickey to make him 6-star, and then we can just push Valk even stronger next time. Thinking process. Oh my. Whoops. Now honestly, the upgrade is too important to not do it, is it? Yeah, we'll do it. Because this is progress. Hell yeah. Okay, Valk at almost 500,000 HP now, which which is pretty cool. Nice. Yeah, she's looking strong, mate, I tell you. She's getting stronger and stronger. What is this? Can we upgrade? Can we upgrade? Yes, we can. Nice. I'm upgrading this thingy right now because it's reducing damage and HP and stuff, which is pretty nice. So yeah, now we can enter this Yidimus place. Let's get a starlight in there and this doohickey. Nice, smashed on. We got some stuff. Let's check out the merchants. That is not too good. Not too bad either. That is bad. That is also not too good. Yeah, I guess we're going to keep this. I'll do it maybe afterwards. What I want to do though is I want to try and push a bit further here in this beautiful place. Maybe we can get like one more smash in, which would be nice. I know though that this boss has one-shot my team every single time so far. Almost one-shot. Yeah, now next active skill is going to be a really bad time for my team. And Vesa doesn't have her active yet, so everybody oh my! Okay, Valk with the burn, saving the day. How nice. Yeah, we're absolutely going to take this additional smash. What do we have here? Not at all. But that's fine. We did get another Heart Watcher copy, which means that we are going to be able to push Heart Watcher at least quite early. But that's not normally what you want to do. You want to push something like a Horus or a Valk early game, definitely. And I'm thinking about pushing Valk to 9 star and then probably foddering her out to a Horus. I'm going to try and go for a Horus as soon as possible after I got my Valk to 9 star, because Horus is just way better than Valkyrie currently. He's also beating her in PvE and stuff. Pretty much everything. Oh, we got plenty of new heroes. That's funny. Okay. Well, anyways, what we can do still though, what we haven't done yet, is we can do some replacements. And I think replacing Melessa here. Whoops, not Heart Watcher, but Melessa. Can we build anything else? Let me look. Ent Elder? No, we have one of her in the bags. We also have a Zekis and a Windwalker, or however she's called. Whatever she's called. And as of in 3 stars, we only have this like horny dude. Not, oh my goodness. I can't believe I've just said that. Oh no. Yeah. Oh no. So we need 2 of these. And 1 of those. And then 3 of the horny dudes. Yeah. Nice. Oh my goodness. That was, well, I'm so confused. How do I have more now? Well, I guess we're going to just use it like this. Because we don't have any more of those. Rhino dudes. That's what I wanted to say. Not the horny dudes, but the rhino dudes. Whoops. Okay, let's go for some replacements. Are you kidding me? What the fuck? Oh, come on. She can't be serious. Oh, come on. There's no way that just happened. Like, there's no way. There is just no way. I'm so upset. I wanted to do some nice swaps right now, just chillaxing, you know. And then he Obi comes in like, hey, can I interest you in our Lord and Savior? Well, Melissa, let's get you out of the bag and let's see. Oh my goodness, I can't believe it. Holy, what is up with the account's luck? I'm saying this and now we're only getting stuff, like, absolutely bad stuff. No, we aren't. Like, what? What? Okay, I'm going to do some micromanagey stuff really quickly. I'll be right back.
Do we have enough 4 stars?
No, locker player spilled. No, not here. While clicking, oh my goodness. It's out of control. Yeah. Nice, okay. So, now let's try it again with our tree, with our Ent Elder. Dude, you gotta be kidding me. There is no way in that. What? I don't understand. I don't understand. I just don't get it. What is this? What is this? I don't get it. I don't get it. Okay. What the f- Rosa, leave me alone. What the hell? Okay. Can you explain to me? What this situation is. I've got 4 roses. What? Like, honestly, I'm out of breath. I'm going to replace Starlight at this point. I don't even, like, what am I supposed to say? I don't understand. This is too much. I need to take her out really quickly, right here. Let's put Rosa in. I don't understand. I just don't. Look, I've never seen something like that. That's 3 Rosas and 1 Oberon. Keep it. Yeah, I guess this is the Rosa account now. Oh my goodness. Okay, Grew. That's, yeah, we can't get Rosa because we're replacing Rosa. That's the only reason. I can't believe it. This is, like, how? How? Like, how? I'm losing my mind. Duh. Oh my goodness, yeah, I've just been rambling on, but I can't believe it, honestly. I just can't. I guess with this beautiful screen, I'm going to head out for now. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, leave a like, leave a comment, and subscribe. If you have any questions, just leave them down in the comments, and yeah. I'm not going to answer any questions how I get so many roses, because I don't understand, honestly. Well, see you guys, have a nice one. Until next time, stay awesome.